Take a seat.
Hey folks, I'm Helmy and I'm here with Ricardo Choo. He's a feng shui master and he's also an expert in Thai Voodooism. He's about to deliver a lecture on Thai Voodoo practices and these are some of the highlights. Can you tell me what this is?
Okay, this wood is known as kaolong. It said that if you use it to hit your body, naturally you'll get an attraction forces. People will begin to like you more, especially the opposite sex.
Okay, so if I hit it on me, like that?
Yeah, you have to keep quite constantly before you meet up with the person you love, before you meet up with superiors or anybody who want to attract.
Okay, what about this one?
Okay, this is actually the corpse chin oil. Actually, it's obtained from the dead bodies and it can be used for attracting purpose as well, especially attracting the public and attracting the opposite sex.
Wow, and then now this is really exotic. This is a cat fetus.
Yes, actually it's a cat fetus.
Show it to them.
Okay, it's said that it will bring good luck to owners and it also warn owners ahead of any dangers coming along.
Wow. Alright. If you want to find out more, just keep watching, okay?
Black magic, there are a few categories. It can be classified into either they put it to the sound, through food, or through other objects that can physically come in contact with the victims, which actually later we'll be taking a look at some of them. Okay, so this one is one of the Thai so-called victim of the black magic. Okay, this lady here, okay, actually, when the parents pass away, the parents leave them some land, which actually the brother and the brother's wife, they're actually not working, but they are actually hiding from the land. But the land was actually being passed to her by her parents, which they believe that she will take care of them well. Okay, so after some time, the brother has been trying to persuade her to sell the land and then split the proceeds of the land for this. So, but she seems not agree because somehow it's being left out by their parents, okay? So, after a while, she said that this person starts to feel that the tummy here starts to inflate a little bit, and it has rust sketch like that of a snake. This one, this thing. It starts to inflate. You can see actually, it inflates it not in the way like water, it's just in an unbalanced position, and some rust pressure or thing, this type of state pressure just occur. So she feels that it's very painful, sometimes it's very itchy, sometimes it's very hot. So she went to seek treatment from this Master Bun Sin in Bangkok. Okay, Master Bun Sin is one of the so-called spiritual master used to be from Sisakhe, the northeastern part. So since he has been a monk since 20-something, so he learned a lot of those Cambodia witchcraft, everything. So he also does the Salika piece of gold. So Master Bun Sin provided me with the pictures. You see, there's a lady who came to him, and then after that, he used the consecrated water to bathe, and then gave her some herbs. And this thing started to dissolve. It doesn't went off immediately, but it does go off. So another story that I related in my seminar, okay, happens to one of my Singaporean friends. There's some years back, about 10, over 20 years back, his friend was a firm believer of a Lama, of the Tibetan Lama. Okay, so after a while, he found out that this Lama is actually not a good Lama. Sometimes he spends money on this thing. So he decided to leave the group. Okay, but this Lama somehow get hold of his birth particulars, all this, when he does the prayers for him in the past. So after a while, he said his friend start to have irregular heartbeat. Okay, irregular, sometimes very fast, sometimes very slow, sometimes very fast, sometimes very slow, okay? So the friend, okay, after consulting a lot of doctor, National Heart Center, he went to NUH. Okay, and then he see one of the higher doctors, like a senior consultant, all this. Okay, but everything is normal. So surprisingly, a doctor told him, you must have got black magic. You better go and see a witch doctor. Okay, it's true. It's true. So no choice. So they took a bus. 18 hours up to Hap Chai, to Patani inside, to look for a monk who has already passed away. So how the monk treats him is that, the monk look at him, the monk know that something is not right. So the monk told him he did some of the consecrated water. So it's that you drink, drink until you're full, you feel like vomit, then you go outside and vomit. Okay, so it really did that, And when you say you're vomiting out, there are a lot of those like sticky things with hair, all these hair and some dirt. So that's how, but because black magic, you cannot physically see how these things move, but somehow they manage to go into the body. Like this lady one, you can see that it really is through food. She suspects that the brother has add some sort of different type of herbs or these from some bread medicine into the food. That's why she got all these. It won't take her life so fast lah. But it may help go through the pain. That's why some people who cannot go through, who cannot endure the pain, they may become insane or whatever. Or people who are in a pain state, they are very easy to be subdued to other people lah. Like you're in a pain, you say, okay, maybe I bring you to help you, bring you to see some other, then you get well already, you have to what? So people use that to obtain some of the motive lah. Okay, this one not that bad lah, okay? Okay, this guy, Master Boon Sin, told me he was from Singapore, but I don't know if any of you know him. Okay, he was from Singapore, Eurasian. He said that this black magic that this guy got is from Philippines. Okay, so he said this guy used to have a Philippine girlfriend. And after he broke off with the girlfriend, he has a wife, actually. Something seems not right. He always feels something struggling on his neck. And he becomes impotent. Okay, that means sexually he becomes unactive already. Okay, so he went to look for Master Boon Sin. He said he's very, very pain. Something always struggling him. So this Master Boon Sin, he said, let's try this out. Last they use normal camera, not digital. No, at that time you cannot immediately see the effect. He said, I take a picture of you first. Okay, nothing. You sit down there. You know, although you see that he's not smiling, very gung-ho like that. Okay, so I take a picture for you first. So he said, after I do some prayer for you, I take another picture again. Okay, then later when the picture develops, you see what's the difference. So when the second picture developed, you see there's something like struggling him. A sort of energy controlling his neck. Okay, so he said that is the cause. So what this Master Boon Sin did, he also prepared the consecrated water to bathe him. But he said this guy went through about 7 days of bathing. Okay, and this Master Boon Sin, he hold a cane in front of, he hold a cane on his hand. So I said, what's a cane for? Because he said that this guy have something that runs in the body, like a worm like that, but they somehow cannot capture him. So once he bathed the water and he drink the thing, he said this thing will start to appear out of skin and he used the cane to hit the thing. Okay, until the thing dissolved. So I asked him, I further probed him. I said, did the guy manage to vomit out the thing? Did you take any picture to show? He said, no. He said it would have already been dissolved already. But I said through the cleansing process, he keep on using a cane to cane this guy, part of the body, whenever he sees something putting out. Okay, and he said after 7 days, this guy doesn't have this strangling problem anymore and so-called his man's power came back without going through any medication or anything. Okay, but Master Boon Sin told me that actually he approached two or three so-called witch doctor, voodoo doctors who tried to help him. And then these people cannot solve his problem. But they cannot solve his problem, it's okay. They pass away within the next few months. So he said he is the one, he came to Singapore quite regularly. I mean, every year he will come twice. But he always told me that Singapore is not exciting. He said, I like to go Sarawak, I like to go Sabah. He said, more challenging the cases there. So actually, he is quite kind to let me have the pictures last year, before the 1 week, 2 weeks before my seminar, I went to see him, and he let me have the pictures to actually showcase how these victims are. I still have one or two more pictures of the victims, but those are not that significant. It's also a woman, skinny woman with a very big tummy protruding out. It's also a black magic cause. It's not like those gumtik or whatever. So, yeah, that one, but I did not showcase the big one. I find these two cases are more interesting, which then that's why I decided to blow the pictures out. Okay, corpse chin oil. Okay, this is one of the very common thing nowadays. In fact, about 1960s, that time still not common, and it's very difficult to get that. At that time, people were saying, the older times were telling me that, this one, if one drop only, you get what you want, okay? It said that this thing, one drop, you rub on the woman's skin or place in her food, which actually it will spread to her organs. She will love you or listen to you or keep thinking of you. Okay, then, in one of the 13th century classic, it was said that a Chinese prince, used it to charm the mother of the beautiful princess to allow her to marry her daughter. You take note of this sentence, this guy used it to charm the mother instead, to allow the daughter to marry her. Not to charm the daughter so that they go Europe, okay? So, you can see how smart and how powerful this thing is. They use it to charm the mother instead of the daughter. Okay, yeah, because if the daughter want, the mother don't want, then maybe the daughter will not give in as well. So, this one, you use it to charm the mother instead of the daughter. Okay, it requires the sorcerers, with very high power to tackle the spirits. And it said that, actually, this corruption wine from this date of this pregnant woman, the Pi Tai Hong, are most powerful. Okay, so how they do it? They say that they will go into a cemetery, okay? They do some procedure, all these, they do some sketch string, they cater around. Then they do some prayer, then they use a candle to burn the chin. Okay, then oil will start to flow down. Okay, why burn the chin and why not elsewhere? You see, in a human body context, okay, usually our hands, legs, they are not that oily. The most oily part is really our face. That's why facial tissue, they sell very well. They don't sell feet tissue, hand tissue. Okay, ladies, they use it, cream, all this. Okay, so that's why when people pass away, within a period of 7 to 49 days, usually the fats, they are still actually keep around the face area. That's why this corpse oil, once they burn this thing, they will start to drip down from the ear, from the eyes, or even from the mouth. Okay, this is the main saying. Then they collect the oil, key in earthen pot, okay? Then they use it for some spiritual purpose, which later I'll explain. Okay, let me see first. Okay, this is a very interesting clip. Okay, this clip made in 1981. I still remember I watched it in the movie theater in this Chinatown, or rental theater, Dongfang, which my mom brought me to watch it. And after that, I start to like a lot. I start to do a lot of research. I think that's where my interest come in. This one is done by one Hong Kong director, Gui Hongzi. He passed away of lung cancer a few years back already. He is one of the best director in doing this Black Magician show because he do a lot of research and how this he interview and he get the Black Magician in. So this clip it shows how the Black Magician obtained the corpse chin oil. And actually some people were asking me, how come is that easy to obtain this sort of thing in Thailand? Okay, in this Thailand-wise, like I said, the temple, they act as a cremation ground. So sometimes some of the dead bodies, before they are being cremated, they will be sent to the temples. Or they will keep there. So sometimes some temples at night, nobody guard, and it becomes an easy target for the thief, for this Black Magician. And sometimes, even the monks, they themselves, they take also. Because I went to one temple, the monk, later I will show you the one that the monk passed it to me. I asked him, he said, hey, how you get it? Go ahead and get it. She said, that day a woman died, pregnant woman died already, put in a temple, nobody can claim. So I went and take lah. Free, you say. This is Chinese acupuncture. It's good to put it under the chin to get the oil. Some people say this guy is a real magician, Black Magician in his real life, but I don't know if it's true or not, this actor.
Take a seat.